So a couple of months or several months ago, I talked about the logic of English and how we were using it. And at the time, it thought it was working really, really well. And it was. It was great. We worked on blending with my oldest. She's really good at hearing the sounds and being able to translate that into the letters. And then we started B. And for a while, I didn't think it was gonna work. They were talking about things like syllables, and it was a lot harder for us to keep going. So I tried a couple of other things. I tried the Good and the Beautiful reading curriculum that lasted maybe a day. I tried like the Charlotte Mason's original method for just introducing words to your kids and then they can read the stories. We did the Little Red Hen from the Treadwell primer, and that also worked well, but when it came down to it, my daughter started asking for dragon work. In fact, my middle daughter, who is 5 but she'll be 6 in the fall, was specifically asking for reading practice and reading lessons. So at this point, my oldest, who is 7 now, she is at the very beginning of B. We haven't finished the first 5 lessons yet, but she's getting a lot out of it. It's taking a bit more time to work with her, and so we're only doing like one of the sections per day. Sometimes we fit 2 in, but it really depends on if she's willing to work with it or not. Because I'm not gonna push her to keep doing something when she's already frustrated. It's not worth it. And my middle daughter, who is 5, the one who will be 6 in August, she is in A now. She specifically asked for dragon work. We were trying to use the Good and the Beautiful, and I was thinking this will be great for her. She'll be able to just move a little bit faster. She already knows the sounds and the letters, but no, she really wanted dragon work. So we're starting over with her. Like I said, she's not even halfway through this yet, but she's really enjoying it. She enjoys the one-on-one time. She knows that, she kind of knows what's coming because her big sister went through it too. I think the biggest struggle that I have with logic of English, it's not so much of a, like the way that they handle it is good. It's just overall, it tends to get more academic. That was the thing I noticed in the samples for C even, that as it goes along, they're looking for parts of grammar, parts of speech, showing what a noun and a verb are, things that kids don't always understand from a young age because they think in abstract ideas and not necessarily, or they don't think in abstract ideas, they think in concrete ideas. So as they get older, they're better able to understand these abstract ideas and you can teach them this information a lot more quickly. But that's just not the case for younger kids. So at this point, I'm not sure, I'm pretty sure we'll end up going through C and D after A and B. My kids just kind of gravitate towards the dragon work, and I think my issue with it is more of my issue, not theirs. I was getting frustrated because there are 2 sounds and then you have to mark a 2 above it, which is Orton Gillingham, and it's not the fault of necessarily logic of English. Some kids just understand it better that way, that is the second sound and it's just a reminder. But overall, I guess I felt it was making it too academic too. I had read in Charlotte Mason's Home Education that, you know, when you make it too academic, that's fine if your child is, like, that's fine for people who study that, but not necessarily for children. And they just want to know what the words mean and what words they see and see the important, know the important words that they can read a story. So I think, we are going to continue with logic of English because that's been asked and begged, etc. But I think we're going to do a little bit of the Treadwell primers too for fluency and for building up fluency. We haven't really practiced a lot with reading out loud. And part of that is because I'm in the mindset of I'm waiting on the readers instead of seeing where my child is and helping her find readers that match her level. So it's not a fault of the program, it's a fault of the instructor. So I think as it keeps going, one of the things I do appreciate is that they go back and they kind of reteach you how to do the spelling analysis. It's not as difficult as it looks in the beginning. I do appreciate them going over parts of sentences and what makes a complete thought, things like that. There's a lot of phonogram practice. There's just so much phonogram practice. Sometimes I feel like it's too much, but again, this isn't about me. It's not about what drives me to tears or boredom. It's about my children and what works for them. So we're going to keep chugging along in B. And I don't know, my middle daughter, she's actually kind of flying through A. I've heard of children flying through A, but I never thought, oh, my kids will just fly through it. There's just so much there. Yeah, she's flying through the first part of A. We can go through two lessons instead of my oldest. We would maybe get through one. So just different learning styles, different learning abilities and how they work and stuff like that. But I just wanted to give you guys an update. Now with the B workbook, the manuscript workbook, I went ahead and I have the HP Instant Ink and the printer, HP printer. So it really is cheaper for me to go ahead, or it's not necessarily cheaper, it's just I'm already paying for it. So I went ahead and I printed off the first section in the B reader. And when we're through with this, like she can actually use this and write on this. I'm not worried about it going away or getting messed up. So we are going to, we're just gonna keep chugging along. And it's been working really well. So, I think that's it. I wanted to give a generalized update that yes, I am still using the Logic of English, and yes, it's still a great program. Yes, there's a lot of moving parts. We don't use the phonogram cards hardly at all. We also don't use the cursive cards like I thought we would because I'm not worried about handwriting with them right now. We are just working on phonograms, spelling, reading, that's it. I don't use, let's see, what else do I know? I do use the letter tiles with magnets on the back because I really feel like that is more conducive to my daughter. She wants to write the letters, she loves writing, but she is having a harder time remembering like how to do some of the letters, so it was just easier to go ahead and give her the letter tiles for now. I think she'll move past that pretty quickly this coming year, but it's been a great scaffolding for her to be able to still spell without being able to necessarily write all the letters correctly. So we do use that, and these workbooks are going to go in my daughter's little Latchmate boxes, which I'm going to do a video on those in just a little bit because I'm hoping that they are what I'm thinking they're going to be, which is pretty awesome. I mean, they're awesome anyway, but I just like having all their stuff together. So that is my update. If you want more information, check out thelogicofenglish.com. You can look at the link below. I'll have one in the description box. So, thank you for taking the time to watch this video.